Hello students, in the last class I explained about photosynthetic pigments and various types of it, that means chlorophylls and also carotenoids, and also we discussed about phycobilins. So these are all various types of photosynthetic pigments, and today's class I am going to explain about how these photosynthetic pigments, they are present in the thylakoid membrane. Yesterday I clearly explained this thylakoid membrane. Hope you remember what is thylakoid membrane. If you take chloroplast, otherwise I'll show you the image and then I'll tell you, then you will clearly understand. Yeah, so this is the image. Now this is the image of a chloroplast. The chloroplast, it consisting of outer membrane and also inner membrane. Because two membranes are present, it is called as double membranous cell organelle. And inside this chloroplast, you can be able to see the fluid material, fluid portion. And this complete fluid which is present in this chloroplast, it is called as a stroma. Stroma means the liquid part that is present in the chloroplast, that you are calling it as stroma. Whereas floating on the stroma, that means suspending on the stroma, you can be able to see these sac-like structures. Aapko dikh rahe na, you just follow my arrow mark, aapko sab samajh mein aayega. So these, see, dekho, a sac-like structures. And these sac-like structures are called as thylakoids. But aapko dikh rahe na, clearly dikh rahe na, these thylakoids, they are present in groups. And this group of thylakoids, that is called as grana. Now you understood, na? Now these grana's, that means this is one grana, let us take this is another grana, and these grana's, they are interconnected with the help of stalk-like structure, and that is called as a stroma lamella. Now you are understanding, na? This stroma lamella means these are connecting two adjacent grana's. And of course, rest of the points I already explained in the previous class itself. It consisting of its own ribosomes, and it consisting of its own food material. It consisting of its own genetic material. Because of the presence of its own genetic material, its own ribosomes, that means protein factory, and its own food material, it do not depend upon cell for its division. Whenever it wanted to divide, it can be able to divide by itself. That is the reason why it is also called as semi-autonomous cell organelle, self-replicating cell organelle. It can be able to replicate by itself. It need not to wait for the cell. When a cub cell divide hota hai, tab I will divide. Aisa, that concept do not exist. Chloroplast is free to divide by itself. Now let us come to the point. So today's point is these thylakoid membranes, they consisting of, see, this is thylakoid membrane. Now let us take this is thylakoid. Okay, now this is grana, and in this one sac-like structure, that is called as thylakoid. And in the thylakoid, you can be able to see this photosynthetic pigments. Now let us go back. I'm really sorry. Yes. Now quintosome means how these photosynthetic pigments are arranged in that thylakoid membrane. This concept basically, quantosome concept basically given by two scientists, Park and Biggins. These scientists in the year 1964, they gave the concept of quantosome. Basically, thylakoids, they are considered as structural and functional units of the chloroplasts. Whereas along this inner side of the thylakoid membrane, there are number of rounded paracrystalline bodies, and these rounded paracrystalline bodies, they are called as quantosomes. And these quantosomes, every quantosome, it is considered as one photosynthetic unit. Now let us take, I am telling quantosome, but basically what quantosome mein kya hota hai? If you come to that point, this quantosome, it consisting of 230 chlorophyll molecules, in that 160 of chlorophyll A. Yesterday, students, you remember, na? Yesterday I explained about chlorophyll A so clearly, and this 70 chlorophyll B, this also I explained. All the photosynthetic pigments I explained yesterday. If you forget, there is no problem. Again, go back to that video. Once you go through that, aapko samajh mein aayega. And along with this 230 chlorophyll molecules, there are around 50 carotenoid molecules. So this is the composition of one quantosome. Okay, like that. Many quantosomes are present in the thylakoid membranes. Okay, samajh mein hai na? Otherwise, I'll give you a very brief revision. If you take the concept of quantosome, point number one, quantosome concept was given by two scientists in the year 1964, and the two scientists are Park and Biggins. Point number one. And point number two is, according to Park and Biggins, they considered thylakoids are the structural and functional units of the chloroplast, in which the inner side of this thylakoid membrane, there are number of small rounded paracrystalline bodies, and each rounded paracrystalline body, it is called as quantosome, and each quantosome is considered as a photosynthetic unit. This is point number three. And point number four is, if you take one quantosome out of many quantosomes, there are many quantosomes in the thylakoid membrane, you take one quantosome, and if you observe one quantosome, each quantosome consisting of 230 chlorophylls and 50 carotenoid molecules. Again, out of 230 chlorophylls, 160 of chlorophyll A and 70 of chlorophyll B. Hope you understood, students. This is a concept of quantosome. Now let us take two pigment system. Students, aapko yaad hai na? This two pigment system was given by Emerson. Emerson is a scientist who gave this two pigment system. Yaad hai na? In the history of the discovery of photosynthesis, in that I explained about many scientists. In that I explained about this Emerson also. Yaad hai na? That Emerson, again I am explaining Emerson contribution, again I am once again explaining. Okay, now two pigment system means, here you need to understand so important point. What is that? You know, these photosynthetic pigments, many photosynthetic pigments are present in the thylakoid membrane, but they are not scattered. See, either I clearly mentioned that point. They do not remain in a scattered form. Then how they are present? They are present in form of groups or clusters. Now this is a very, very important point. In the thylakoid membranes, so many number of photosynthetic pigments are, pigment molecules are present. Chlorophyll A, chlorophyll B, carotenoids, phycobilins, like that. Again, carotenoids make carotenes, xanthophylls, and also if you take phycobilins, phycocyanin, phycoerythrin, like that. These are all various types of photosynthetic pigment molecules. Many photosynthetic pigment molecules are present in the thylakoid membranes, but they are not present scattered. That means they are not present like wherever they wanted to be, like randomly they are not present. They are present in organized groups, and these organized groups are called as photosynthetic units. That means it is called as a photosystem or pigment system, or it is also called as light harvesting particles or light harvesting complexes. You write anything, but meaning is same. So you need not to worry about it. Light harvesting complex you write, or light harvesting particles. Now we understood, na? Again, I'm telling you, if you take two pigment system, now if you take a thylakoid membrane, in the thylakoid membrane, many photosynthetic pigment molecules are present. This is point number one. Point number two is, this many photosynthetic pigment molecules, they are not present scattered. They are present in a organized, well-organized groups. And these groups are called as photosynthetic units or pigment systems or this light harvesting complexes. Okay? Now, such complexes are of two types. What are they? Pigment system one, or simply you write photosystem one, and the next one is photosystem two. फॉर एग्जाम्पल आई एम जस्ट एग्जाम्पल के लिए आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग यू. लेट अस टेक 10 क्वांटाजोम्स आर देयर. इन द 10 क्वांटाजोम्स देयर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ क्वांटाजोम्स. सम क्वांटाजोम्स लेट अस टेक 5 क्वांटाजोम्स आर फोटोसिस्टम 1 एंड 5 क्वांटाजोम्स आर फोटोसिस्टम 2. होप नाउ यू अंडरस्टूड ना. जस्ट एग्जाम्पल के लिए ऑफकोर्स देर आर मेनी क्वांटाजोम्स दैट आर प्रेजेंट इन क्लोरो दिस थाइलाकोइड मेम्ब्रेन्स. I am telling only for your understanding. Okay. Now, if you take the differences between photosystem 1 and photosystem 2. Now, photosystem 1, the important pigments that are present in this photosystem are chlorophyll A, chlorophyll B and carotenes. Whereas, photosystem 2, it consisting of chlorophyll A, chlorophyll B and phycobilins, that means carotenes are little less. Okay, whereas here these photosystem 1 and photosystem 2, they are basically composed of what? They are composed of photosynthetic pigments. And just yesterday itself I explained you what is the job of photosynthetic pigments. They can be able to trap the sunlight at their own range. For example, chlorophyll A it is having its own range. Chlorophyll B, it is having its own range. Chlorophyll C, it is having its own range. All the photosynthetic pigments cannot be able to absorb the light at the same wavelength. Every student cannot be able to understand at the same level. Every student has their own understanding levels. Some student, they will understand. If I explain once, they will understand. Sometimes they expect the revision. That is about some other students like that. Students ka understanding level kaise alag alag hota hai. This pigments ka light absorbing capacity also alag alag tarika mein hota hai. Hope you understood na. Now these all photosynthetic pigments, they are present in the photosynthetic pigment which is composed of various types, chlorophyll A, chlorophyll B and carotenes, and they absorb the light. And when they absorb the light, finally they gets excited at the wavelength of 700. So that is the reason why P700. What is the meaning of P? P means wavelength. At the wavelength of 700, the excitation of these electrons takes place. What is the excitation of electrons? Sir, I am not getting you. Please don't worry. What is the meaning of excitation of electrons? I will explain in the just next class. The very next class, I am going to explain what are these electrons, from where they came from. Don't worry at all. Every answer you will get it. But all the answers I can be able to explain now itself. Na? Just now you understood. Electrons here, they get excited at the wavelength of 700. Idhar tak aap yaad rakh. And next class, that means just tomorrow only, I am going to explain where these electrons are coming from. Okay. This excitation of electrons, they takes place at the wavelength of 700. That's why the wavelength of 700, it acts as a reaction center. Whereas here, the reaction center is at the wavelength of 680. I really know what is your difficulty while you are listening. What is your difficulty? I'm understanding from where, what sir is explaining, from where these electrons came from. Just wait for one class. For now, this class, you just remember, electrons, they get excited at the wavelength of 700. And definitely in the next class, I'm going to explain that. Okay. Whereas photosystem 1, it lies on the outer surface of the thylakoids. Whereas photosystem 2, it is present towards the inner surface of the thylakoids. For example, if you take, this is a thylakoid. These thylakoid may, the outer surface may, you can be able to see the photosystem 1. And the inner surface may, you can be able to see photosystem 2. Understanding it? Now, if you take a photosystem, either it may be photosystem 1 or it may be photosystem 2, basically their arrangement is same. Photosystem 1 and photosystem 2 arrangement is exactly similar, but their excitation wavelengths are different. See, let us take the first one, photosystem 1, the excitation state, it is showing at the wavelength of 700, whereas photosystem 2, it is showing at 680, except their excitation points. their reaction centers, the structure is exactly same. For example, we are all human beings. Our basic structure, morphology, the anatomy and also physiology is exactly same, but someone are becoming doctors, someone are becoming actors, and someone are becoming any other thing, that some are becoming teachers, that means basically all these particular photosynthetic pigments which are present in form of various photosystems, all these photosystems are basically same in their composition, but their excitation, it varies. Photosystem 1, if you take, they excite at the wavelength of 700. Photosystem 2, if you take, they excite at the wavelength of 680. Hope, I think I explained in a very easy way. Still, if you don't understand, you can definitely ask any doubt to me, okay? Now let us take the structure of the photosystem. If you take one photosystem, so this is a thylakoid membrane. This is thylakoid membrane. See, it is mentioned also here. This is all thylakoid membrane. In the thylakoid membrane, you can be able to see this composition exactly similar to the plasma membrane. Plasma membrane also, it consisting of lipid bilayer. Yadena? In cell biology, I explained about the plasma membrane structure. The plasma membrane structure, it consisting of lipid bilayer. So in the thylakoid also, you can be able to see lipid bilayer. So this is one layer and this is another layer. So two layers are present. That's why I'm calling it as bilayer. Now these photosystems are embedded. Embedded means immersed inside. Immersed inside means they are present inside. If they are present inside, then that is called as embedded. Okay, so these photosystems are embedded in the thylakoid membrane. See, dekho, ye pura membrane hai. And beech mein kya hai, what is center mein kya hai? These photosystem got embedded. Okay, now if you take this photosystem, it may be photosystem 1 or it may be photosystem 2. As I clearly told, photosystem structures are exactly similar, but they differs in their excitation. Photosystem 1, it gets excited at the wavelength of 700. Photosystem 2, it gets excited at the wavelength of 680. Ye cheez, you know, this point you have to remember. Otherwise, you will confuse, okay? Now, so this is the structure of the photosystem. A photosystem, it consisting of various pigments. It may be phycobilin, or it may be keratin, or it may be chlorophyll B, chlorophyll C, chlorophyll D, like that. There are many photosynthetic pigments. So you just follow my arrow mark. So now these all photosynthetic pigments, they are present around this reaction center. Ab dikh raha hai na? This I think this is gray color. If I am correct, this is gray color. And this gray color, it is called as a reaction center. Okay. Now around this reaction center, various number of photosynthetic pigment molecules are present, and every photosynthetic molecule, it can be able to absorb some amount of light. Okay, light, yesterday you remember my class, no? Light, it produces it consisting of small packets of energy called as a photon, and each photon, it consisting of some amount of energy, that is called as quantum energy. Quantum energy you can call, or otherwise you can also call it as a radiant energy. See your comfort and you call, okay? But meaning is same, okay? Now every photosynthetic molecule, let us take, this is chlorophyll B, so it can be able to absorb some amount of energy, and it transfer to other, and it transfer to other, and it transfer to other, like that. All these photons, they trap some amount of energy and they will pass to other. Again, they will absorb some amount of energy, and again they will pass to other, and again they absorb some amount of energy, that means quantum energy, and they pass on to other. Like that, every photosynthetic pigment molecule, it absorbs some amount of light and it pass on to other. Now all these photosynthetic pigments, they are also called as antenna or light harvesting complexes. What is the meaning of antenna? See, it's a very common understanding. Now, earlier days, I'm not talking about recent days. Earlier days, there is a kind of antenna which is made up of aluminium foils. Aapko yaad hai na? I think you are too small. Okay, let us take your days only. Now, Uber, for example, if you take a Tata Sky or Airtel, you are watching this what you call channels, na? Discovery Channel, Cartoon Network, dikh raha hai na? In that, for that you need to arrange this dish TV. For the dish TV, Uber, you can be able to see some kind of antenna, some kind of receiver. Receiver ka job kya hai? It take the signals. है ना, लाइक दैट एज इट इज यू कंपेयर दैट द डिजिटल सेटअप विद द फोटोसिंथेटिक पिगमेंट, इट रिसीव्स द सिग्नल्स वेर एज इट रिसीव्स द क्वांटम एनर्जी, दैट मीन्स लाइट एनर्जी, ओके, फ्रॉम द फोटॉन्स एंड दे पास ऑन. सो दिस हाउ दिस पर्टिकुलर डिश सेटअप इट टेक्स इट रिसीव्स द what you call it receives the information and it will pass on to the TV, so that the TV screen may, whatever the channel you are watching, you are getting the data. Like that, it receives the light and it receives the data, and the data, it is called as quantum energy, and it will pass on to the reaction center. So reaction center is a TV now, and whatever the energy they are receiving, that amount of energy they are taking, and they are getting excited at the wavelength of 700, so that आपको टीवी में व्हाटएवर द मूवी यू आर वाचिंग दैट मूवी यू कैन बी एबल टू सी. लाइक दैट व्हाटएवर द एक्साइटेशन दे वांट दे विल गेट इट. नाउ यू अंडरस्टूड ना? सो जस्ट कंपेयर विद द कॉमन डिश टीवी with this particular photosynthetic pigment molecule and reaction center with this particular TV, whatever the channel you are watching. Now it is, I think so it is clear, but still single doubt, even single word also, if you don't understand, you please ask me again. I'm just giving a very small recap so that you can understand still more better. Let us take, this is a thylakoid membrane. Thylakoid membrane, it also consisting of lipid bilayer, because two layers are present. This is layer number one and this is layer number two. Two layers are present, so it is called as a lipid bilayer. And in the lipid bilayer, you can be able to see all these particular various photosynthetic photosystems. It may be one or it may be two, like that, so many are there. I am taking only one. If you take one photosystem, it may be one or two, because basically their structures are exactly same except their excitation points. Okay, now if you take a photosystem, it consisting of various photosynthetic pigment molecules. What are they? Chlorophyll B, chlorophyll E, chlorophyll D, and phycobilins, xanthophylls, like that. There are many photosynthetic pigment molecules, and all these photosynthetic pigment molecules, they are together called as light harvesting complexes, or you can also call it as antenna. इधर तक समझ में है ना? And antenna का job क्या है? They receive the signals. Like that, here the photos in this light harvesting complexes, they receive the sunlight and they excite. Okay, sorry, they receive the sunlight, and in the sunlight they absorb the quantum of energy and they will pass on to the other, and thereby it reaches to the reaction center. Okay, now this reaction center, it consisting of the universal photosynthetic pigment molecule. Yesterday I told you na, aapko yaad hai na, the universal photosynthetic pigment molecule is nothing but chlorophyll A. So all these pigment molecules, they absorb some level of some amount of sunlight and they finally pass on to the chlorophyll A molecule, whereas this reaction center, it consisting of two chlorophyll molecules. This is one, dikh raha na, arrow mark dikh raha na, this is the first one and this is the second one. So there are two chlorophyll A molecules and they receive all the energy that is given by these molecules, and finally they gets excited. They show their excitation point at the wavelength of 700. Now we understood na? So this is light harvesting complex, which is also called as antenna. This is number one, and number two is a pair of chlorophyll A molecules, number two, and the number three is it consisting of primary electron acceptor. So these are the three parts of the photosystem. The first point is light harvesting complexes, which consisting of various photosynthetic pigment molecules, and each photosynthetic pigment molecule absorbs some amount of light and it pass on to the other, and finally all these photosynthetic pigment molecules, they convey their energy, they pass on their energy to the chlorophyll A molecule. These chlorophyll A molecules, two are present, and they gets excited at the wavelength of 700, and they pass on the electrons to the primary electron acceptor. So these are the three components of the photosystem. First component is light harvesting complexes, which is composed of various photosynthetic pigment molecules, and second one is reaction center, which consisting of two chlorophyll A molecules, and the third component is primary electron acceptor. So hope you understood what is photosystem, photosystem 1 and also photosystem 2. Structurally they are similar. Hope you understood na? And if you don't understand, please ask me, I will explain again. I will again take one more video lecture, I don't mind, but you have to understand. Why I'm itna insist kyun kar rahe na? If you don't understand this, tomorrow's class also you don't understand. Okay, so this is a very very important concept. This structure is a basic structure. If you don't understand the basic structure, main aage whatever I explain aapko samajh mein nahi aayega. So please be very frank. If you don't understand, you directly ask me, you can message me, and again I will make one more video on it. But finally, conclusion kya hai na? You need to understand this particular diagram. Otherwise, you don't understand the other classes. Okay. Now, let us go for another one. Now, one more topic, absorption and action spectrum. To be frank, it is not one more topic. It is a continuation of photosynthetic pigments only. To be frank, yesterday's class ka continuation only today's class. Okay. Absorption and action spectrum. What is the meaning of absorption and action spectrums? Let us see. You take any photosynthetic pigment molecules. I already told you what is the meaning of photosynthetic pigment molecules. The point what you need to understand is pigments absorb light at different wavelengths. All the pigments cannot be able to absorb the same wavelength of light. Every pigment has its own capacity to absorb the light. So now if you take any pigment molecule, okay, the pigment molecule at which wavelength it is absorbing the light, if you draw a graph, and that graph it is called as action spectrum. I repeat, because you need to understand, let us take one pigment molecule. That pigment molecule at which wavelength it can be able to absorb the quantum of energy, that means sunlight, then that wavelength of light, if you draw a graph, and that graphical representation it is called as absorption spectrum. Now you understood na? Let us take a very common example. I called some students for lunch. Okay, some student can be able to have let us take one student is there, that person can be able to have two rotis. So his absorption capacity is two rotis. That means let us compare the student with the pigment molecule, and how much he can have, at which wavelength they are absorbing more sunlight, then that is called as absorption spectrum. For example, some people, they don't like rotis. For example, if I make a nice biryani, they eat more. That means that is their absorption capacity. For example, if I make a nice kheer, they eat more. So kitna kha rahe hai, and which item kitna jada kha rahe hai, and that is called as absorption spectrum. Now you understood na? Let us consider this student only pigment molecule, and kitna kha rahe hai, that only absorption level. Okay, and if you plot a graph, then that is called as absorption spectrum. Let us take, and students, this is a graphical representation which is showing the absorption of chlorophyll A and chlorophyll B. Let us take chlorophyll A, it having absorption peaks at this blue and red lights. Now let us take, this is blue, this is VBGR, okay, violet, indigo, blue. Aapko pata hai na, visible light, it consisting of seven types of colors. In that, the photosynthesis, it actively participate. That means the rate of photosynthesis is more in blue and the red lights. The at this point you remember na? Now let us take, see, this is a blue light and this is a red light. Okay, now let us take chlorophyll A molecule. Now the chlorophyll A molecule, it is showing more absorption in blue light. Dikh rahe na aapko? Follow my arrow mark. See, I am going to draw a straight line. So blue light, see, it is showing the peaks, hai na? So this is called as absorption spectrum. That means at which wavelength of light the photosynthetic molecule it is absorbing more amount of quantum energy, then that is called as absorption spectrum. And again, it is also absorbing red light. See, this is red, hai na? See, this is one more peak. And that means if you take chlorophyll A, it absorbs more quantum of energy in blue and the red lights. Understanding it. So in blue and red, it is showing maximum absorption of quantum energy. That's why blue mein ek peak hai and red mein dusra peak hai. So this peak, this graphical representation only, it is called as absorption spectrum. Now you understood na? Absorption spectrum can be measured by using spectrophotometer. Understanding it? Spectrophotometer, this is a device which is used for measuring or for plotting the graph of absorption spectrum. Now you understood na? Now action spectrum. Action spectrum matlab kya hai na? Again, I will take the same example so that you can understand. One boy is there, he ate two rotis, and after he had two rotis and he attended for two classes and took down and he noted all the points. That means after eating some amount of food, that person kitna kaam kar rahe, then that is called as action spectrum. Like that same example, now I will convert. See, ek photosynthetic pigment molecule, it is absorbing some amount of light. By absorbing that amount of light, kitna rate of photosynthesis it is performing, that is called as action spectrum. Aapko samajh mein aa raha hai na? I think so. I am giving you basic example. This basic example definitely you can understand. Ek bachcha hai, he is having two rotis, and by having the two rotis, that boy kitna kaam kar rahe, then that is called as action spectrum. Kitna ka rahe, that is called as absorption spectrum. That much he ate, and by eating that much, kitna amount of work he is doing, then that is called as action spectrum. See, the curve showing the rate of photosynthesis at a different wavelengths of light is called as action spectrum. Now let us again go back to the graph. इतना एब्जॉर्ब किया ना, सो दिस क्लोरोफिल ए, नाउ इतना एब्जॉर्ब करने के बाद इतना अमाउंट ऑफ फोटोसिंथेसिस इट इज परफॉर्मिंग. सी द कर्व, इट इज शोइंग, यू आर फॉलोइंग माय एरो मार्क ना? सो इतना अमाउंट ऑफ द फोटोसिंथेसिस इट इज शोइंग. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड एज एक्शन स्पेक्ट्रम. अगेन अ वेरी वेरी ब्रीफ समरी, जस्ट इन वन मिनट में आई फिनिश इट. एक्शन स्पेक्ट्रम मीन्स if you take one photosynthetic pigment molecule, you take any pigment molecule what you like. I am taking chlorophyll A because this graph is actually representing chlorophyll A. Okay, now if you take chlorophyll A, that chlorophyll A, at which wavelength of light it is absorbing more amount of quantum energy, that is called as absorption spectrum. Samajh mein hai na? Now that much amount of energy it is taking, by using that amount of energy, kitna amount of photosynthesis it is performing, then that is called as action spectrum. I think it is very clear, but still if you don't understand, I am always ready to solve all your doubts. Okay, now let us take most important concept, that is Emerson's enhancement effect and red drop. Okay, and students, you don't write all these. Okay, this I wanted to explain Emerson's enhancement effect. To explain this Emerson's enhancement effect, mujhe ye sab chahiye. That's why I brought all this information. So all this information you need not to even remember also. Just I want something to explain for this Emerson's enhancement effect and red drop. For that I brought all this. So see, a very studious work to draw all these things, so please don't waste your time. This is basically for your understanding, please remember this. Okay, if you take visible light, you know na, sun, it propagates the light, sun it produces the light, and the light it consisting of various forms of what I call radiations like X rays, gamma rays, and also UV rays, IR rays. Ecology may also, I already explained in that our Earth can be able to receive only the light from 390 to 760, and this much amount of light only our Earth can be able to receive. Remaining light, they are getting reflected. All these points, आपको याद आ रहा है ना, दिस ऑल पॉइंट्स आई ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन इन द इकोलॉजी. इन द इकोलॉजी आई एक्सप्लेन एवरीथिंग सो क्लियरली. सो अर्थ इट इज कवर्ड बाय ओजोन लेयर. सो बिकॉज ऑफ द प्रेजेंस ऑफ ओजोन लेयर इट कैन बी एबल टू रिफ्लेक्ट ऑल द हार्मफुल लाइट रेस, एंड इट कैन बी एबल टू फिल्टर ओनली द यूजफुल रेस. सब याद आ रहा है ना, सो दैट ओनली आई एम रिपीटिंग इट वंस अगेन हियर. ओके, now Earth it receives the light which is ranging from 390 to 760, and the light which is received by the Earth which is present in the range of 390 to 760, that only you are calling it as visible light. Now you understood now what is visible light. I'll repeat it safety ke liye, once again I'll repeat it. Earth it receives the sunlight, but all the sunlight which consisting of various radiations, they can't be able to come on to the surface of the Earth, because the Earth it is covered by ozone layer. This ozone layer it reflects all the harmful radiations, and it will receive the light which is ranging from 390 to 760, and this light it is called as a visible light. Now I think you understood. Now this visible light, it basically consisting of seven types of colors, seven types of lights. What are they? Violet, blue, green, yellow, orange, and red. So basically these all together called as vibgyor. Of course hamara normal pronunciation is this vibgyor, it converted into vibgyor. Of course pronunciation problem chhod do, I am not taking any English class, but hope you understood na. So this is called as vibgyor, and each and every light has its own wavelength. Let us take violet. If you take violet, it is showing the wavelength of 390 to 430. If you take blue, the blue light it is showing 430 to 470. If you take green, 500 to 580. If you take yellow, 580 to 600 nanometers, whereas orange it is showing the wavelength ranging from 600 to 650. If you take red it is showing the wavelength of 660 to 760. So these are the wavelengths of lights, understanding it. And after red you can be able to see, that means so idhar tak red hai na, now red 760 tak hota hai, and but our range is raises a little more. So after this red, the amount of red light it is received, that is called as far red. Okay, that means this is red, and thoda aage if you go, it is called as far red, and far red it shows 700 to 760, understanding it or not. Now these are various wavelengths of light it is shown in vibgyor. Vibgyor means various colors that are present in the visible light, but the amount of light received by the Earth, it is ranging from 390 to 760, but in that only 400 to 700 only will be considered as photosynthetically active radiation. You know what is photosynthetically active radiation? I clearly explained it in the ecology. The amount of light which is helpful for the photosynthesis, that is called as photosynthetically active radiation. Though Earth is receiving from 390 to 760, only 400 to 700 only this photosynthetically active. That's why this radiation, it is called as photosynthetically active radiation. Very simply you can call it as PAR. Hope you understood. Again students, I'm telling you this complete slide only for your understanding. Again don't draw it in your books, because it is a very studious job. Aapko hai na dikkat badh jayega, that's why don't go for this. Our topic kya hai na, this is our topic, emergence enhancement effect, or it and also red drop. to explain this, I brought all this information. Okay, now let us go for actual topic. The actual topic is Emerson's enhancement effect and red drop. What is this? If you want to know these two, I need to tell you two very, very important words. What are that? You know, the first one is quantum requirement and the next one is quantum yield. Unless if you understand these two, you can't be able to understand what is red drop and Emerson's enhancement effect. So I will explain quantum requirement and quantum yield first. Now let us take the first one. Quantum requirement means, yesterday aapko yaad hai na, I told photosynthesis, it is releasing some amount of oxygen. It is utilizing carbon dioxide and it is releasing some amount of oxygen. A point aapko yaad hai na, even I told in yesterday and also the day before yesterday class also. That means two classes I told. In the photosynthesis, carbon dioxide, it will be converted into C6H12O6. That means food material. And it is taking the carbon dioxide and it is releasing oxygen by the breakdown of the water molecule. A sub points aapko yaad hai na, same point you please recollect. Now quantum requirement means number of quanta, that means number of photons. You know na, what is the meaning of photon? Photon means small packets of energy that is present in the sunlight. It is called as photons, and each photon, it consisting of some amount of energy, and that energy, it is called as quantum. Aapko yaad hai na, ye sab points yaad hai na? So number of quantas that are required for the formation of one oxygen molecule in the photosynthesis. In the photosynthesis, a pura photosynthesis mein ek molecule oxygen milne ke liye, banane ke liye, kitna quantum of energy chahiye, that is called as quantum requirement. And Emerson calculated each oxygen molecule banane ke liye, formation ke liye, it need 8 quantas, that means 8 photons. अभी समझ में है ना? Now let us take quantum yield. Quantum yield मतलब क्या है? एक quantum, that means one photon में कितना energy है, that is called as one quantum कितना oxygen formation contribute कर रहे, then that is called as a quantum yield. Okay, very simple ना. Now कितना quantum चाहिए? If you wanted to make one molecule, इधर है ना 8. Now एक quantum कितना contribute कर रहे, that means simple equation. सोचने के लिए जरूरी नहीं है. What is that? 1/8. So 1/8 if you take, that means one quantum, it is contributing 12.5% of oxygen. That is so simple, very simple thing. Okay, now let us take what is red drop. You understood this too, na? If you understand this too, red drop is just so easy. Now the decrease in the quantum yield after far red region, that means beyond red region of the visible light spectrum, then that is called as red drop. I'll explain. For this only I brought, actually this is no need, but if I don't explain this, aapko samajh mein aayega. So for your understanding only I brought all these things. Now let us take photosynthesis. It is taking place from violet, blue, green and all. Now at once, either थोड़ा ऑक्सीजन मिल रहा है, इधर थोड़ा ऑक्सीजन मिल रहा है, इधर थोड़ा ऑक्सीजन, लाइक दैट ऑक्सीजन मिल रहा है. नाउ व्हेन द फोटोसिंथेसिस इट क्रॉस्ड रेड, इमीडिएटली यू कैन बी एबल टू सी द डिक्लाइन इन द ऑक्सीजन फॉर्मेशन. सो द अमाउंट ऑफ ऑक्सीजन डिक्लाइन आफ्टर क्रॉसिंग रेड, दैट ओनली इट इज कॉल्ड एज रेड ड्रॉप. नाउ यू अंडरस्टैंड? सो ईजी. द डिक्रीज इन क्वांटम यील्ड, व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ क्वांटम यील्ड? ऑक्सीजन, कितना ऑक्सीजन मिल रहे है. सो द डिक्रीज इन द क्वांटम यील्ड आफ्टर क्रॉसिंग द रेड रीजन ऑफ द विजिबल लाइट, एंड दैट ओनली इट इज कॉल्ड एज अ रेड ड्रॉप. कितना इजी है, बट स्टिल इफ यू डोंट अंडरस्टैंड, आई एम ऑलवेज रेडी टू आंसर योर डाउट्स. ओके, नाउ द सेकंड वन, होप यू अंडरस्टूड व्हाट इज रेड ड्रॉप. नाउ लेट अस टेक द सेकंड वन, Emerson's enhancement effect. It is really a kind of tricky thing. What happens, you know, Emerson, he in the year 1957, he observed when both short and also long wavelengths. What is the meaning of short and long wavelengths? I think you must have understood, but still safety ke liye main bol rahe. Short means less than 680 wavelength, and long means what? More than 680 wavelength. Now when you strike both short wavelength and also long wavelength simultaneously, the quantum yield, it will be increased. Now you understood now what is the meaning of enhancement. What is now ये biology छोड़ दो. Basically what is the meaning of enhancement? बढ़ रहे. For example if something it is getting increased then that is called as enhancement. Am I correct or not? Now the quantum yield it will be enhanced. That means increased when you simultaneously propagate short wavelength also and long wavelength also. When you are propagating both short and long wavelengths simultaneously, the quantum yield is increasing. And that increased quantum yield, when you strike both short and also long waves, long wavelengths of light simultaneously at once, then that is only it is called as Emerson's enhancement effect. Now you understood, na? Whereas if you strike short wavelength separately and long wavelength separately, definitely quantum yield aayega, but bahut kam aayega. If you strike short and long wavelengths simultaneously, aapko quantum yield zyada aayega. And zyada aata hai na, that's why it is called as Emerson's enhancement effect. Hope you understood today's class, students. And today's class is a so important class. If today's class, if you don't understand, next all the classes you never understand. So please understand what is the importance of today's class. If you don't understand, please don't hesitate. At least 1% also don't hesitate to ask me to make another video on the same topic. I am ready to make one more video, but my conclusion of today's class is you have to understand today's class. If you have any doubts, please ask me. Thank you so much.